as it once was. This is NBA Live. Here, you can be the one and shine like the league's best. Anybody can get shook or dunked on or crossed up. And your newfound control over your strength, skills, and style is a beautiful thing. So do you want to be the one or the one who gets left behind? You have the ability to dominate on both ends of the court. It's all in your hands now. But remember this, the path to being the greatest, being the one, does not stop at the NBA. The game continues in the playgrounds, the schools, and the local gyms. This is where every real player developed their love for the game, where they paid their dues, earned their reps, and rode their own wave. From pickup games at the Rucker, to pro-am games at the Drew, to the bright lights of the NBA, the paths to greatness are limitless. And trust me, this game ain't the same. Are you ready to be the one?
I ain't see the difference. You ready to be the one?
Now, it's time to choose your player's height and weight. Every choice you make here will affect your player's physical capabilities, both good and bad. So choose wisely before you lock in.
She only want me cause I'm nav. Girl, I didn't buy that bag.
I ain't buying.
I don't want no one that's in the mix. You talk to all the rappers saying that and this. Every time I'm buying, I'm paying cash. I just spent 5,000 nonsense.
I just wanna take a.
I asked her if she wanna win. She see the XO on my back and now she in.
See the XO, now she in.
Yeah, I'm ballin' way above the rim. Threw her the keys and told her take it for a spin.
Take the Lambo for a spin.
I'm worth a couple tickets trying to get these M's. I call my mama, said we'll never be broke again. I remember being broken down bad. Now I pay nothing for my sneakers cause I'm nav. He can't get a feature, so he mad.
Yeah, he mad now.
I ain't nothing like these rappers, they won't last.
They won't last now.
I don't wanna call her, now she's sad. Cause I'm getting money, money, and living fast.
Living fast now.
Every time I dress, I'm popping tags.
Poppin' tag now.
And every time I'm buying, I'm paying cash.
Paying cash
Like millions of other kids, you dreamed of one day being in the NBA. You wanted to be a star, and someday to rise above and become the greatest to ever play. You dreamed of being the one. But the road to stardom is never easy. There are obstacles, injuries, and disappointments. Adversity is universal. It can happen to anyone. At any time. And one day, it happened to you. You went from being a guaranteed lottery pick to a kid who may never even play college ball again.
Now look, it's always bad to hear about injuries, especially to college kids, of course.
Yeah.
But Stephen A. Smith, this one is particularly disheartening. Because we are 2 weeks into the season, and one of the top NBA prospects in the country goes down potentially with a season-ending injury, a knee injury. That's a killer.
I couldn't agree more. When I heard he was carried off the floor today, all you can do is find yourself hoping that he'll make it back. That's the bottom line. But my heart goes out to him because I didn't expect this. This is a devastating injury. It's never good to have something like this happen to you.
The team doctor broke the news. Torn ACL, sprained MCL, and a torn meniscus. Surgery was scheduled, but your game will likely never be the same. At the 2016 NBA draft, your name is still mentioned. Not as a prospect, but as a cautionary tale.
Now, there's another huge story in this year's draft. A record number of underclassmen, 30 of them, undrafted. And I hope, anyway, that this is a lesson, this serves as an example to college players. I'm not talking about the ones who are genuinely one and dones, the guys you know are going to be lottery picks. I mean the rest of them. They're not sure shots. You're not sure they're going to be lottery picks. Don't just use the college system for a year thinking you're going to bounce. It doesn't work like
please,
that. If you don't have the talent, it doesn't work. You got to be cultivated
please,
in the system.
Please, please. There you go again with your blanket generalizations. You know how you are, oh, Max. The woe is me. Oh, my Lord. I can't take it. I just can't take it. It's a case-by-case basis. You can't just blanketly decide this should not be one and done or this should be one and done. You got to go on a case-by-case basis. Some dudes deserve to be one and done. Some people don't. It's on a case-by-case basis.
And that is my point. Thank you for making it for me. Every kid thinks they're the exception to the rule. And members of the media like, Stephen A. Smith are encouraging these kids to come out early.
Look, Max, bottom line is this. You got to take this into consideration. You had two dudes. They were called the Hype Brothers. Now, you had Nick Howard. This kid had a lot of promise. What does he do? He goes to college. Very uneventful first year, no doubt. The second year, he was pretty good. Here's the problem. The NBA, it's not about pretty good. You need to be great on the collegiate level, on the prep level, in summer leagues and what have you, in order for you to get the stature that you deserve. That's the bottom line. You're pretty good ain't good enough to
That's
be that stud
point.
NBA.
How That's is exactly point? My
Let
point.
Let me finish. Let me finish. There's another example. I just say the Hype Brothers. I wasn't talking about one individual. I was talking about two. What happens? One and done in a different way. 1 year, one ACL injury later, and look where he's at now. His future is clearly uncertain. So you got to take advantage of that opportunity because you never know when an injury is going to cost you everything.
Stephen A., listen to yourself. Let's listen to yourself for a second. You give one argument for why a kid should come out early, a one-and-done situation. I can give you 30 arguments this morning alone why they should stay in school. And now you have to wonder what a kid like Nick Howard, who has given up his college eligibility, does next. What does he do next?
First of all, don't sweat the technique. The argument, or one argument, as long as it's strong enough, that's all that matters. That's number one. Number two, the Hype Brothers was something special. What they really, really need to do, and I'm going to tell you what they need to do, Max. They need to get back to playing together. My sources are telling me the ACL injury has been completely healed. So go on a pro-am circuit. Go in summer leagues. Do what you got to do to get back on the court together to remind everybody of what you once were. Because once you pull that off, the sky's the limit. That's what they need to do. Get back to playing ball together, because when people see what you can do as one, the other arguments don't really matter. Like I said, don't sweat the technique.
I'm here. Came, I ain't tripping on a past flame. Even if they were dimes, how many tens want my last name? Is this the rap game or high school politics? Boss could be on Maury because they got a little pop in it. Before I show up, that's when the deposit is. You only want me now. That's what I have problems with. 5-star suites was on the floor. That's the aesthetic when you getting half a mil on tour. Not bad for 6 weeks. Plus, I should receive my plaque soon. On the game, I'll probably hang it in my bathroom. Last June, I was broke. This June, I made 100. Before and after, didn't change me, though I stayed 100. Show me someone else who's doing what I'm doing. Singing, rapping, mixing, mastering, engineering, producing. That's every song with no exception. Plus the catalog longer than a lot of veterans. Mention me amongst myself, cause I'm the first of my kind. You live a semi-charmed life, cause your third eye's blind. I'm a shepherd, not a sheep, but I heard it's my time. Was in the shadows for so long, I deserve on my shine. Got some women you would love left on red. Got some homies about that arm leg arm. I should call the night. Can be dangerous. You let them behind the scenes, all of a sudden they start making up to alter her perception of me. The older you get, the more expensive lessons will be. Gotta tighten.
This is New York City, the mecca of basketball. The original Rucker League began here in 1947. 9 years later, the tournament found a permanent home uptown at PS 156 Playground. Those early Rucker days showcased talents like Lou Alcindor, Wilt the Stilt, and Earl the Pearl. It's also where Julius Erving became the doctor. In 1974, the park was respectfully renamed Holcomb Rucker Park in honor of the tournament founder. Now, many have influenced the growth of the Rucker since, but none more heavily than the late great Greg Marius, founder of the EBC. Many would argue that the Ruck is the birthplace of true street ball and the crossover dribble. Considering New York City's penchant for flashy guard play, there are few who can challenge that. After the legendary exploits of Rucker alumni like Rod Strickland, Rafer Alston, and Kyrie Irving, it goes without saying that getting crossed up or banged on can happen to anybody at any given moment here. It's no wonder that this unassuming uptown playground has become the most widely recognized streetball court in the world. Rucker Park, Harlem.
sun shines brightly over the high court of uptown hoop dreams, precariously divided between Washington Heights and Inwood. Between the whistles and beneath the project towers is where a young Luau Cinder changed from a boy to the prototypical big man, perfecting the skyhook and agility unprecedented. Part and parcel of a history fathoms deep, where 3,000 highlight-hungry fanatics crowd the fence weekly to bear witness to the greatness of guards like Eric Opio, a.k.a. El Presidente, disrupting any and all defenses. J.R. Smith and Kemba Walker perfecting their seasonal alley-oops and step-backs. Dominican Power raining long-range crossover dreams on Uptown's friendliest rims. Young men with names like Too Hard to Guard, formerly known as Idris De Leon, before his handle made him the stuff of legend, New York City's Black Top Kingdom. Many would say this is the most entertaining outdoor ball in the city. Between the lines and in the paint, and with a style and grace that can only be found uptown, we are New York City basketball at its very best. Dykeman.